Hello and welcome to Tushka Training. We're back in Hit Film 2 Ultimate and today we're going to be creating a 3D laser bolt or lightsaber effect. When people do this, normally they use the lightning effect. And if you've watched some of our previous tutorials, you know I'm a big fan of using the lightning effect for various different things. But the reason I'm going to do this a slightly different way today is because somebody wanted to actually do a shot where the laser bolt was fired from the laser and went directly into the camera's view, and it travels quite a distance and it needed to look completely in 3D, and this way I think it works quite well, and it doesn't really use much more GPU than the lightning effect, to be honest. So it's worth trying this effect if you need the full 3D appearance. So the first thing we're going to do is gonna create a new composite shot. We'll call this shot container. And we're going to create a new plane. I'm going to make this the color that we want of the laser. In this particular case, I'll leave it red. We'll call this laser bolt. If you're making a lightsaber, then you can name it accordingly. Name it whatever you like. Next thing we're going to do is we're going to use atomic particles. We're going to drag atomic particles down. We're going to open up the atomic particles properties. Number of particles we are going to change to 200 on the X, 1 on the Y, and 1 on the Z. And as you can see, there's actually nothing on screen. I don't know why that is, that single particle is actually off screen, but it is. And the fix to that is to just change your scales down, like so, and then bring the scale of the X down as well, just so it's laser sized, sort of. That's good enough, it'll do. We'll go to particle appearance. We're going to change the size to 15 just to give it a bit more bulk. Size random, we're going to put at 0. Opacity stays at 1, opacity random at 0. The rest of the particle appearance looks fine to me there. I think that's about it for the actual laser bolt itself. What we will do is create a new point. We'll rename this to laser control. And now in the atomic particle settings, we're actually going to go to position and transform from laser control. But before we do that, I forgot to make the point 3D. So we'll just make the point 3D quickly. And then we'll change it to laser control opinion and the transform from. Now, when I move or rotate or transform the point, you can see that we have a fully 3D object. What we will do is bring the camera in a little bit closer, like so. And now when I rotate it, you'll see that it is actually completely 3D. And if you were to move the camera right into it, you would get that laser bolt effect. One of the things I did straight away when coming up with this effect was I automatically just stuck a neon glow on it, like so, and then on the neon glow just change your color to red, and you can bring the radius and the expansion down to wherever you want it to be to get the exact look you want. And we basically have a nice 3D laser bolt that can be tracked and so on because it's controlled by a point. I hope you enjoy this quick tutorial and we'll see you on the next one.